Last week, I had the honour of attending an international health ministers meeting in Sweden on behalf of the Honourable Tony Rail. I gave a paper on fine-tuning of healthcare. It was very pleasing that New Zealand's system has stood up very well over the last 4 years, or 5 years, under the national government, compared to the previous 9 years under Labor, where health spending doubled and productivity and outputs declined. In sharp contrast, under National, although we have slowed the increase in spending, we've increased productivity, we've increased outputs, and we have had spectacular success with health targets. For instance, with immunisation, whereas 5 years ago, only 67% of two-year-olds were fully immunised. Today, 95% are fully immunised. Whereas 5 years ago, in 2006-07, many New Zealanders were having to wait 2 to 3 months for cancer therapy, and some have to travel all the way to Australia. Today, every New Zealander, when their doctors recognise they need treatment, are treated within 4 weeks in a New Zealand expert hospital. This is absolutely world's best practice, gold standard treatment. The other area, of course, is elective surgery. There were huge waiting lists right throughout the Labor regime up to 2008. Today, we're carrying out more than 35,000 elective surgeries per year than there were in 2008. I think, generally, the New Zealand health system shines as one of the great successes of the national government, and it's yet another example how, through better public services, through looking at every level of the health system and concentrating on frontline services, New Zealanders are being well served.